is a silver pen. Can it be a silver pen and not a silver pen? I would say that depends on the perspective or the context. But first of all, is this a silver pen? That has to be established first. We have to establish this thing's identity before we can even start to talk about it, before we can even say that it is itself. We have to say, this pen is. A equals A. All right. I've mentioned it before that A equals A assumes that A-ness as a concept is possible, is viable. In other words, A equals A has an assumption in it. It has a place to stand that is sort of built in. I won't say that it's a loaded question because it's not a question, but I would say it's a loaded equation. But equations can't be other than loaded. You can't have an equation that is devoid of content. Content is an assumption. So instead of me actually abolishing A equals A, which I'm not trying to do here, in spite of what some people might think, I'm not trying to abolish identity at all. I'm just trying to make sure that we understand identity for what it is. Identity is a construct. So rather than say A equals A is wrong, which I've never said and I'm unlikely to say, what I would say is, if A is, then A equals A. If, and that's a big if built into this, if identity itself is a viable concept, a viable construct, whatever you want to call it, if it is, then things are themselves. That's if we accept identity, and acceptance of identity is built right into A equals A. Before you can even say A equals anything, you have to say that A is. So, instead of A equals A, my equation would be, if A is, then A equals A. But again, we've got a conditional in there. We've got an if. The other point that that keeps coming up here is this idea of non-contradiction. Something can't be A and not A at the same time. Well, I've mentioned this angle to this. This is a pen, and even if I accept this thing's identity as a pen, does it have other identities? Of course it does. It's an object that was manufactured somewhere. It's more than just a pen. It's a piece of plastic. It's a part of the bureaucratic culture in which I operate every day. I work in a big office. We use pens a lot. It's also a potential artifact for early 21st century civilization. It's also part of the economy of a town somewhere that manufactures these. It's also part of somebody's income who imports them to Canada. It's also a means by which I can draw portraits or write calligraphy or dash off correspondences. It's any number of things that I choose to attribute to it, any number of attributes that it has. Even after we have established its identity, it has as many identities as we care to bestow upon it. I can write an entire novel on this pen and never really refer to how it writes. I can talk about the economics behind the production of pens, even if we don't even go into what this thing is used for at all. Or I could talk, and economics is the one I keep harping on, but there's any number of things. I could talk about the plastic industry. I could talk about the science behind the production of plastics. I could talk about the geopolitics of the petroleum industry, because that's where plastic comes from. So this is anything, depending on context. This one's really going to get people mad, but can this be a pen and not a pen? Can this be A and not A? I'll leave that up to you. But I'll put it this way. You don't need to believe in mumbo-jumbo to sort of acknowledge that A can be A and not A. Ever heard of singularity theory? I'm not talking about mumbo-jumbo and Shiva being good and evil at once, or, square circles or stuff like that. I'm talking about the point where the laws of physics get odd. Singularity theory. Square circles are hypothetically possible. Again, this kind of thing happens when you take all points of reference out, where you take all places to stand away. Give me a place to stand, and I will move the world. What if there is no place to stand? Let's make sure that where we do stand is solid. Rather than trying to abolish the universe, that's all I'm trying to do. I'm trying to say that when you set your feet at the sort of fulcrum of your universe to sort of say, this is where I'm going to build everything from, don't kid yourself. It's going to be arbitrary, or at least it's not going to be as defined or as definite or as solid a place as you think it is. There's nothing wrong with that, provided you understand that it's all conditional. It's all conditional of saying, this is where we start. And this is where we start? Try finding a fixed point in science or in philosophy. It's all down to assumptions.